Hi, this is Shubham from MonisU, and today in this podcast, we will discuss what is an asset allocation, what are the various types of asset classes. If you want to read the full article about this, then the link of article is in the description. So let's start. If you have ever cooked a meal, you will know that the ingredients you choose to put into a dish are very essential, as the recipe, how much or how little of an ingredient you add can make or break the item you are preparing. Your investment portfolio is not a different one. However, what asset class, that is equity, debt, cash or even gold in form of commodity, you choose to add to your portfolio and in what proportion, also referred to as an asset allocation, can make or break your portfolio. So it is very important to have a proper mix. So here is a question: what is an asset allocation? Saving and investing are two different things. Merely saving money does not amount much, since factors like inflation negatively impacts the value of your cash in hand over the time. Meanwhile, as an investor, you are consciously invest your saving despite risks to create a wealth which is your reward. You also look to protect this wealth from factors like taxation and inflation. So what is an asset allocation and what does it have to do with an investment portfolio? As a part of your investment strategy, you use saving to buy assets from financial market, which could be either company stocks or government bonds or even gold. Each asset class react differently under various market conditions and to real world events. For example, in time of warlike conditions, stocks and debt markets may slump while gold prices appreciate. So that the idea of a well balanced portfolio means your asset allocation earn you on an average steady return over the investment. A poorly designed portfolio could mean that you may not be successful in achieving your financial goals, which could either be built for your children's education or buying new car or house or even your retirement corpus. Since you make an investment decision with an eye on a future guided by your aspiration and anticipated requirements, your short to long term goals and your risk appetite determine how your portfolio shape everything along with your future goals. So what are the different types of asset classes are there? Formally, we can say that there are only two classes. First, equity and debt. So what is an equity? These are some of the most popular asset class that can be part of your portfolio. Equities are the key to the generation of a return and capital appreciation. It's also known to every investor that an investing is an art. Paint a picture of what you need are and how much is your risk appetite. Staying realistic is the best way. Know that not every day is sunshine. If you are going in it for the long term, patience is necessary despite the rise or fall of an equity market. The second class is of course debt. This is essentially the market for fixed income securities issued by either central or state government or public or private company looking to finance their projects. Debt market instrument could range from a couple of days to a few years. The market is considered less volatile than equities. Other assets are basically the commodities, or you can say saving in gold, bullions or other real assets including cash in hand. But broadly, there are only two type of assets: equities and debt. How is allocation different from a different classes for the diversification? Asset allocation is the proportion of various asset classes that make up your investment portfolio. Diversification could either be between asset classes or between asset within the particular class of asset. Suppose you are in the process of building your investment portfolio and decide to invest 60% in equity, 30% in debt and 10% in gold. That is the breakdown of your asset allocation. What makes up 60% in equity will also determine whether your portfolio is well diverse or not. If the equity section of your portfolio only contains blue chip stock, which can say a large market cap companies, then it is safe to say your portfolio is not well diversified. Diversification could also refer to diversification across investment style and whether you have a diversified globally so that the impact of a local market crash does not impact your entire portfolio. Let's say if there is a recent crackdown on education startups in China, which has impacted a lot of education startups. But if you have diversified your portfolio in US or any other emerging market like India or Brazil, this won't have majorly impact on your portfolio. That's why diversification is necessary within the class of asset as well as within the class in different segments and parameters. So let's discuss what is the bottom line over here. Proper asset allocation and diversification are both essential to ensure that a single significant economic event or a policy change does not render your entire entire portfolio in the negative. However, you design your portfolio is subject to stage of your life at the present and at the future you are foresee for the yourself and your family. But more importantly, how to maintain your wealth is an important as how you create it. That is, your investment portfolio is not a one-time matter to handle and then forgotten. Instead, just like you would care for a plant, it needs to be a constant attention. So thank you guys for joining with us for this podcast. If you want to read the full article, then the link of article is in description. Here, Shubham from Monistio signing off.